Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will continue with the same lesson and we have reached up to the last point, that is the revolt of 1857. And in the last lecture I have explained you about the battle of Plassey and Buxar, why the battle of the Plassey and the Buxar took place and which were the different policies used by the Britishers to exploit the Indians. Now children, the Britishers were formally established in India and they started exploiting our Indian farmers in different way. Means they were too much exploited that they were asked to pay the heavy taxes and they were asked to sell the product at the low prices, and also they were not allowed to get the permission to open the mills or the textile industries. Now children, these exploitation and this dissatisfaction among the Indians led to the revolt of 1857. The revolt against the Britishers started. People in the different parts of India had been protesting against the various policies used by the Britishers. The revolt of 1857, according to the historian, was a landmark, was a very important landmark in the Indian history. The revolt of 1857 was also known as the first war of independence, because the Indians decided that by anyhow Britishers are exploiting us by using the various means, so we have to fight against them for our independence, and the Indians started to fight for their independence. The revolt of 1857 was started by the Indian soldiers in the British Army. The reason of the revolt was the introduction of the rifles. The rumor was spread that the rifles which were used by the Indian soldiers, the cartridge of the rifle was greased by the fat of cows and pigs, and the cartridge, the covering of these cartridge had to be bitten off before loading into the gun, and this the covering of the cartridge was to be bitten off before loading into the gun, and this meant that the soldiers had to put this cartridge in their mouth. So children, it was against the sentiments of religious sentiments of Hindu and Muslim soldiers, and the soldiers were not ready to use these rifles, and so these became the main reason of the revolt of 1857, and the Indian soldiers refused to use this rifle and a revolt started. The revolt of 1857 began at Meerut, and soon spread to the northern and the central India. It was joined by the farmers, craftsmen, merchants and traders, and the superiors also, and marched to the Delhi. It was joined by the farmers, craftsmen and the other sections of the Indian society. The Indian soldiers overthrew their superiors and marched to Delhi to crown Bahadur Shah Zafar, the last Mughal emperor. Indian rulers such as Rani Lakshmibai, Tatya Tope, Nana Saheb also joined these rebel, and Rani Lakshmibai was defeated. Rani Lakshmibai was killed in this revolt, and Nana Saheb continued the battle. This revolt continued for 2 years before it was crushed by the Britishers. But children, what happened? The mutiny failed because it lacked the proper leadership and the planning. The Britishers had the strong army. The Indians, the economic condition of our Indian was not very strong, and because of this, the proper planning, and it doesn't, our Indian army was not very strong to protest against the British army. And also children, the Britishers that time has used the policy of divide and rule, and the many rulers in India were with the British army, and this was also one of the main reason why the Indians were defeated in the revolt, because our Indian rulers were not together. The Indian rulers were also fighting among themselves because the Britishers had created the misunderstanding among the Indian rulers. The lack of the unity among the Indian ruler was also the main reason for the failure of the revolt. British army was so strong and they had very superior warriors. The Bahadur Shah Zafar was exiled to Burma and there he died. And he died as he was the last Mughal emperor. With the death of the Bahadur Shah Zafar, the Mughal emperor came to an end. And the British, the our India was now under the direct, was under the, was our, and our India was directly under the British crown. The revolt was a turning point in the Indian history. The rule of the East India Company ended and India came under the direct control of the British crown. So this is about the revolt of 1857. Children, this way today we have completed the lesson. Read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. Thank you.